Installing a whole house water filtration system from Culligan helps trap sediment and reduce scale that can clog faucets, ruin plumbing, and damage water using appliances that you depend on. By connecting a whole house water filtration system to your main water feed, all water coming into your home will have to pass through the filter before being routed to faucets, showers, toilets, dishwashers, washing machines, and water heaters. It also pre-filters water before reaching other in-home filtration devices, such as water softeners and drinking water filters, making them even more effective. Culligan offers a full line of quality whole house water filtration products that you can install on your own. Culligan's lineup features a variety of housing styles, user-friendly features, capacities, and filter cartridge replacements so you can install the solution that best fits your unique water challenges and budget. Let's take a look at installing one of Culligan's most popular and most advanced whole house water filtration system, the WH-S200C, which features a 3/4-inch inlet for the more common 3/4-inch pipe. If you have 1-inch pipes, you can choose from one of Culligan's 1-inch inlet models, which install similarly. The WH-S200C comes with a clear housing, a housing wrench, a P5 filter, and a mounting bracket. It has an easy grip bypass valve and a battery-operated filter life monitor for added convenience. For installation, you will need a pipe cutter or hacksaw, two adjustable wrenches, a file, two 3/4-inch compression fittings with ferrules, Teflon tape, a Phillips screwdriver, and a marker. First, let's find the best place to install the whole house filter. It must be positioned after the water meter, pressure tank, or pressure booster pump, and must allow enough room on either side of the housing and fittings for installation access. There also must be enough room below the unit for the housing to be removed to allow for filter changes. Plan for at least 1.5 inches. A sturdy surface to install a mounting bracket provides added rigidity to the installation, but is not required. Once we have a location, turn off the water supply and open the nearest faucet to drain pipes. If using the optional BRC mounting bracket shown here, ensure that the position of the housing is consistent with the direction of your water flow. In this case, the water is flowing from left to right. Align the holes of the bracket with the holes on the back of the filter head. Insert 4 mounting screws through the bracket and into the filter head until tight. Next, let's prepare both compression fittings. Apply Teflon tape in clockwise direction to pipe threads of each adapter. Start adapters into filter head by hand. Use a wrench to tighten firmly. Be careful to not over-tighten. Now, with the housing unit prepared, let's mount to the wall. If your pipes are too close to wall to accommodate the depth of the whole house filter, as they are here, you'll need to install the unit by adding 2 sets of 3/4-inch compression elbows and some extra piping. In order to determine how much pipe needs to be removed for the installation, measure the overall length of the configured system, adding some additional room to work with on either side. In this case, we added about 4 inches to each side for a total measurement of 17 inches. Mark the section of the pipe to be removed. Using a pipe cutter or hacksaw, cut and remove marked section of pipe. Sand or file the rough edges. And then add compression fit elbows and additional piping at appropriate length away from wall. Add second set of elbows to each side. Now attach the housing to the wall using the mounting bracket and 4 mounting screws. With the filtration unit in place, let's measure and cut incoming and outgoing pipes, careful to account for the engagement depth on the elbows and the compression fittings. Slip brass compression nut and ferrule onto the end of the incoming pipe. Insert pipe into elbow on left and push firmly for solid engagement. Then press pipe firmly into the compression fitting. Using 2 adjustable wrenches, hold incoming fitting securely with 1 wrench and tighten nut with the second wrench. Repeat process for outgoing side to connect to outgoing pipe. The WH-S200C we are installing here comes equipped with a P5 filter in place. If for some reason it has been removed, or if you are installing a different model, now is the time to install the filter cartridge, making certain it slips over the standpipe at the bottom of the housing. Then carefully screw into place, making sure the cartridge slips into the standpipe in the filter head. Ensure the filter housing has been properly tightened using the housing wrench. Turn the bypass valve to filter mode using the handle of the housing wrench for added leverage. Then slowly turn on the main water supply. Slowly press red pressure relief button on top of the filter to release trapped air. Check for leaks. Open nearest faucet and flush filter cartridge for 5 minutes. Reset filter life indicator by holding reset button for 2 seconds. And the system is good to go. As a homeowner, you are now ready to enjoy the benefits of reduced sediment and scale, including cleaner faucets, sinks, and showers, along with longer lasting, better performing appliances.